fellas, hey girls, welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes and doctor's office or hygiene center or whatever the hell you want to call it. With the new coronavirus or whatever they call it going around, it's spreading because people are not taking preventative steps. And this is with any virus or any a common cold, for instance, can spread.
The way this virus spreads is by direct contact with a carrier or being within close proximity.
So let's look at some things that you can do to prevent you from getting infected with any viruses. Common sense is the number one key, and hygiene is another thing. What do you do the most? What do you touch the most? Number one, you use your hands to touch things and do daily things, all right? So you gotta keep them clean. But if you wash them a lot, they're gonna dry out. You're gonna dry, and your skin can dry out and crack. So you need to put an aloe-based hand lotion on them, a moisturizing hand lotion with say aloe in it, to prevent that. But that attracts germs also. That does. So what you can do is wash them good and wear some comfortable fitting gloves. Get a large size. They make a translucent or clear type glove that's very loose fitting, and you don't have to wash your hands as often. You can wash the glove in a bleach, a diluted bleach solution, which you should keep in your kitchen to wipe down your sink and your countertops with. I've got one right here. It's just one part bleach, three parts water, and a little spray bottle. Spray down everything. You need to get some like those Clorox wipes, those antibacterial wipes, or you can make your own. You can get these little scrubs and put some bleach, diluted bleach and water in them, and just one of those throwaway takeout containers, okay? Keep them in that and use them to wipe down everything. What do you touch the most, okay? Doorknobs. Handles, the handles on your car, your vehicle, your steering wheel, your shifter. Okay, wipe those down. Another thing you touch a lot is your faucets, your faucet handles, your toilet handle. You should be using some type of bleach-based toilet cleaner in your toilet. When you mist down an area with bleach, let it sit. Don't just wipe it right up and use a clean rag or a paper towel or something that you're going to throw away. And you know, if bleach bothers you, you need to find another product that doesn't really have bleach in it or it's not as strong, but something that kills 99% germs. This is one product. There's many of them out there, but you can make your own. And if you're gonna do something in your vehicle, like say wipe the seats down or something, the leather seats, some products can cause them to dry out and crack. So be sure it's safe for that. The same way with fabrics. You gotta watch. You know, if you've got cloth seats in your vehicle, certain things may bleach them, you know, change their color. So do a little test swatch somewhere that you can't see, like fold your seat forward and get back in where it folds forward. You can usually expose some of the material and put a little bit right there and check it the next day and see does it fade or change colors. Because you don't want to mess your vehicle up naturally. Now vinyl or plastic seats, you can do whatever the hell you want with them. You really need to keep your whole house clean. And shut up, doorbell. Go away. I don't want to talk to nobody. That's probably the Amazon dropping something off, they always ring the doorbell and take a picture of it. Anyway, yeah, your floors, mopping your floors, keeping your house clean, dust free, that kind of thing. You know, a common air filter is just going to remove dust from the air. If you're really concerned about the air quality inside your house, you can call a HVAC contractor and get him to install a ultraviolet or UV light in the ductwork that will kill bacteria. They use them in hospitals. They use them in the operating rooms. Matter of fact, after they clean the whole operating room down with a bleach-based solution or a virus-killing solution, they have UV lights in the fixtures that you can't look at them with your eyes. They can damage your eyes. So they'll close that room off and turn the UV lights on. They're very strong. They can cause sunburn on your skin. They can cause cancer on your skin. So you don't want to be exposed to them. And they leave them on for a kill. And they'll leave them on for X amount of hours. And it sterilizes the room, basically. But you can get that same technology for your ductwork in your house. And the reason I know that is because I'm an HVAC contractor, or retired. Another thing you can do, and the people in China are doing this, wear a hospital type mask. Wear it on the street. It'll be a fashion statement, meaning that you're not stupid and you don't want to catch what you have. Same way with the gloves. If they don't like it, slap them. Also, your soap. Make sure the soap you buy says antibacterial on the packaging. Okay? Some are better than others. This is one of the best, according to doctors. If you're not sure about a product, go to,
something I left out is when you buy a bottle of pop or a canned drink, wipe the top down good.
Consumer Reports, and see what they say about it, because they're unbiased and they rate all kinds of products. Your shampoo, okay? This is one that they use in hospitals. I know because I was just in the hospital and they would give you this. It's a moisturizer, it's got aloe in it, and it's also a body sanitizer. You can use it as a sponge bath. That's another thing about your sponges. You want to throw them away after a week or two. You know, don't keep them for 6 months because they are bacteria breeding grounds. You can run them through your dishwasher a few times. You can even put them in the microwave, and that will kill some of the germs on them, but I don't think it's going to kill all of them. It may piss them off is what it may do. Other products is your feet. Humans' feet have more sweat glands per square inch than any other part of your body by tenfold. Okay, so with that in mind, you need to use some type of powder in your shoes. This one has aloe in it to prevent your feet from cracking and drying out, because you don't want that to happen either. So, you know, when you bathe or whatever, do wash your feet well with a bacterial, antibacterial soap. And you need to keep your shower stall clean and that kind of silly thing. The sink, your toothbrush, turn it so it can drain and get air on it.
Put a little mouthwash on your toothbrush every time after you use it to sanitize it.
That's another thing about draining dishes. When we come over here, if you've got a wet dish that the dishwasher didn't dry, for instance, turn it where, don't just set it flat down on a towel like this, because moisture will stay inside of it. It'll take several days for it to dry out and bacteria can start to breed in it, possibly. So prop it up to where it can, it, it, it can get air up under it. They make special mats like they use in bars or restaurants that have those little dimples in it to where it can, air can circulate on it and help it to dry. If you don't have an automatic dishwasher, you need to get a sanitizer, not just the soap. You use the soap, you rinse the soap off, you dip it in the sanitizer, then you rinse it in a separate container with clean water. Then you dry it, all right? You gotta scrub the food off before you hit it with the soap. Oh no, the damn phone. Shut up, phone! Non-union phone. Automatic dishwashers, don't skimp on your, don't try to turn the drying heat cycle off or abort it, because that raises the temperature inside your dishwasher to like 160 degrees, which kills bacteria and germs. Okay, that's the minimum that they go to. And if that heating element is out, you need to call a service technician or replace it yourself. So don't short on that. Do use your dishwasher if you have one. If you don't, you need four containers to really clean dishes. You need a soap container, fresh water container, a sanitizer, and then another separate water container. You don't go back into the one that you rinse the soap off with. That's how they do it in barrooms for all their glasses. And at restaurants, they use a commercial dishwasher. Your fingers, they touch everything, right? Clean up under your fingernails. If you can't afford a fingernail brush, use an old toothbrush and clean them well. When you wash your hands, don't just kind of do like this and sling them dry. A surgeon will wash his hands, his whole forearms, for about 20 minutes using a surgical type soap. Now you can do it with any dishwashing soap, but keep in mind that make sure you get something that's antibacterial, because normal dishwashing soaps, a lot of them are not antibacterial. They're primarily made for grease. But this brand happens to be cool, huh? So it will do some things, depends on how long it's in contact with the germs. Like I said, the best way is the dishwasher. And your cell phone, you touch it all the time. Don't wet it, don't dunk it in the sink. What you need to do is get your antibacterial wipes and wipe it down daily. I'm serious. If you use a keyboard and a mouse, do same with them to wipe them down. They get quite nasty. And I really can't stress that enough, because they did an experiment at a school that one of my granddaughters attends. And they took some bread, clean bread with gloves on, and they put one in sealed it in a Ziploc, burped the air out. And they did another one, they wiped it on a cell phone. They did another one, they just wiped it on a countertop or a desk. They did another one, and they wiped it on a toilet seat. And the worst looking one, they also just rubbed their hands on one. Just a regular, come here, boy, rub your hands on this, okay. The worst looking one was a cell phone. It had the most amount of mold growing on the bread after, I think it was 2 weeks or 3 weeks, something like that. The next one was the hands, naturally. The toilet seat happened to be the cleanest one. Go figure. Because it's cleaned more often, that's why. So I hope y'all learned something from this. I hope you don't get sick and die, because this is a serious virus, because they haven't found any meds that will work on it yet. Viruses are funny like that. When new ones come out, they're immune to the old antibiotics, and so they've got to come up with a new one. And viruses are smarter than you think. The symptoms are, for this new virus, feels like you may be coming down with a cold, you got the sniffles, you can carry that for about 2 weeks. And then it can just, bam, bust your butt. And doctors sometimes misdiagnose it. So, you know, if you feel like you're coming down with a cold and you haven't been taking care of what I mentioned in this video, then you need to go see a doctor and say, check me for
arnovirus.
However you say it. I'd have to look at it to say it. I looked at it a little while ago, but I've got too much else on my mind right now. Did I miss anything? You know, your oven self-cleans itself, or cleans itself. Once it's over 200 degrees, if there's anything alive in there, it ain't gonna be happy and alive for much longer. It's gonna die. You know, naturally, your pots and your pans, put them in the dishwasher. Or do the four-step wash routine. Yeah, that means you're gonna have to have, if you got a three-compartment sink, you're gonna have to have two more containers to do it in. Or if you got a two-compartment sink, that means you're gonna have to have two more containers. A three-compartment sink would need one more container, right? Right? Right. When you sneeze, if somebody else sneezes, get out of the area, walk away. When you sneeze, at least do it in your shirt sleeve or a handkerchief, a Kleenex, paper towel, something. Try to avoid spreading germs. And if you're sick, don't leave your house. Call somebody. Have medicine delivered. Most drugstores will deliver. You know, call a friend. Call your mama and them. Bring me some medicine. Don't let them in. You reach through the door. I'll tell them, just set it by the door and I'll come get it. You don't want to infect them. No kidding, huh? Yeah. To prevent it, education is going to be the best key, or to prevent it from spreading, should I say. Education is going to be the best key. So, you know, tell your friends about this video. Tell them to watch it. I know it's long-winded, but needed to be as thorough as what I could, and I think I did cover it pretty well. If you didn't catch on, watch it again. A boy, a girl, a bye.